Rosemary Frankland, a beautiful 18-year-old from Lancaster. Miss United Kingdom declared the judges is the new Miss World. Bob Hope performed the coronation ritual. It was an emotional moment, especially as the lovely Lancashire lass is the first English girl to win the title.
It's a home win for our own Miss United Kingdom, Anne Sydney, now Miss World. She has the cloak.
Miss World 1963 hands her crown.
And now the crowning ceremony by the retiring title holder, Carol Joan Crawford, who now places the crown upon the new Miss World, who is Anne Sydney, 20 years old. She's a hairstylist.
Miss United Kingdom. Miss World 1965, Miss United Kingdom.
So the new Miss World is once again Miss United Kingdom, Leslie Langley, who is 21 years old. Her statistics, to remind you, 37, 24, 37. She's a blue-eyed blonde and a model. The cloak is placed around her shoulders. And now it's the turn of Anne Sydney, the retiring Miss World, to place the crown on her head. Always a tricky operation. Will it work tonight? All in one go.
Kingdom. Fifth place to Miss United Kingdom.
She received a check for £100 and a silver trophy.
Bonnie Scotland, Sheena Drummond, Miss United Kingdom. She hopes to make it a hat-trick by winning the Miss World contest as well as the two others she just won. She's just come back from South America, and all we can say to her is, Lang me yalumrik.
Miss United Kingdom.
Understandably, a partisan greeting for Miss United Kingdom. 21-year-old Yvonne Orms from Nantwich, who's a photographer's model. Her main ambition, self-confessed, is to visit Russia.
Miss United Kingdom.
There's the face that everybody in this country knows. Portugal and Miss United Kingdom, man and war.
Miss United States of America. United Kingdom.
Well, that's a hometown cheer for Jenny McAdam. Now, what a striking entry, too. She's brown hair, hazel eyes, tall girl, 5'9", plays the guitar.
Miss United Kingdom.
And, of course, no shortage of support for Veronica Cross. Veronica's 23 and lives in Peacehaven.
Miss United Kingdom.
Well, the applause was going as soon as she appeared at the top of the steps. This Helen Morgan with this meteoric rise to fame. It was only back in June she won Miss Wales. In July, runner-up in Miss Universe, September Miss UK, and now here in London, looking for Miss World. Helen Morgan from Wales.
Miss World 1974 is Miss United Kingdom.
She's done it! She's done it! Helen Morgan, my goodness, what a career! Only in June, Miss Wales. She goes on to be runner-up in Miss Universe. She goes to Blackpool and wins Miss United Kingdom, and now she's Miss World. The fourth girl from the United Kingdom to win it. Rosemary Franklin, Anne Sidney, then Leslie Langley, and now Helen Morgan. What a career. £3,000, the Miss World Championship trophy, the cloak now being put around her shoulders on that so famous throne, the 24th Miss World. There goes the crown. 56 other girls, of course, now watching this. Julia Morley now crowns Helen Morgan as Miss World. Put it straight. Miss United Kingdom.
And as you can imagine, a lot of home support here tonight in the Royal Albert Hall for Vicky Harris, the 22-year-old model. Vicky's been doing quite a bit of travelling just lately since we last saw her on television, I think, when she won Miss United Kingdom in Blackpool in August. Just come back from Malaysia, in fact.
Third Miss United Kingdom.
Great delight for Vicky Harris, and great delight too here in the Royal Albert Hall for 22-year-old Vicky Harris. She receives a cheque for £1,000.
Miss United Kingdom.
Well, I hardly need to introduce Carol Jean Grant from Glasgow, whose one ambition in life is to become Miss World. She's also got some hobbies, which include playing the piano and collecting continental dolls. Lots of men I know have that hobby as well. She's an accomplished pianist and loves sad and sentimental love songs and films.
Fourth Miss United Kingdom.
Oh dear, intense amount of disappointment in the Royal Albert Hall. But pleasure too, knowing that Carol Grant has got so far. Miss United Kingdom stepping up to receive her prize of £500.
One can say that we saw her shimmering in that perishing cold up in Blackpool in September, and here she is tingling with excitement in front of this 5,000 people here in the Royal Albert Hall. Madeline Springer from Miss Shields, 24-year-old model, and looking inching every inch a winner, I'd have thought tonight. Madeline Stringer, Miss UK.
Miss United Kingdom.
Elizabeth Ann Jones. Fairly predictable reaction from the audience here at the Albert Hall tonight. She's a fashion model. And her languages are Welsh, although she does admit not fluently. She's a member of the Women's Royal Volunteer Service, and her paternal great-grandfather was Bugler Jones, portrayed in the film Zulu. Miss United Kingdom.
We see again Miss United Kingdom, Carolyn Seward. Carolyn is very popular with the girls and with the bookmakers. She's the favorite to win this contest in her home country. Carolyn has had formal ballet training and loves to ride horses.
And the runner-up is Miss United Kingdom, Carolyn Seward. The beautiful hometown favorite settles for second place.
She was Miss Wales in May and became Miss United Kingdom at the end of August. She's a fashion and photographic model and shows in the way she walks that she's had training in movement and dancing, all kinds of dancing, modern, ballet, mime, national, tap, Greek, the whole caboodle, she says.
Fifth Miss United Kingdom.
Fifth place, Miss United Kingdom, that's Kim Ashfield, goes to receive her check for £500.
Miss United Kingdom.
Yes, getting a very warm welcome in the hall tonight. This is Michelle Donnelly, of course, with a Grecian style, a bit like Jean Harlow's dresses. Very low back, trimmed with gold, and it suits her blonde hair admirably, doesn't it?
United Kingdom. A wonderful romantic ballgown for Della, very feminine combination of gold silk chiffon over pink silk taffeta. You notice the deep peplum and the detail of the metallic roses of the neck and the waist.
Second runner-up is Miss United Kingdom.
Yes, that's Della Dolan. She collects a prize of £1,000 in cash and her runner-up trophy, of course.
Miss United Kingdom.
What a cheer for Sarah Jane from Poole in Dorset. Chosen this gown with all her knowledge of fashion as a model. Stunning red taffeta and chiffon enhanced with this fine gold embroidery.
And Miss World 1983 is... Miss United Kingdom.
She is the happiest girl in the hall tonight, Sarah Jane Hutt from the United Kingdom, now Miss World, with prizes in excess of £30,000. Miss United Kingdom, Vivian Rook.
wearing royal blue velvet and silk taffeta. Mandy was a school champ at gymnastics. She's obtained awards in gymnastics, swimming and trampolining. She wants to be a model. That's Miss United Kingdom.
First runner-up, Miss United Kingdom.
As the first runner-up to Miss World, prizes totaling £2,000, that should make Mandy Shires from Bradford very happy. And here's Miss United Kingdom.
Alison Slack. And she is a fashion model. And Alison, she's wearing a black silk dress with a long bodice. It's got a floating lovely skirt. It's all embroidered in silver sequins and beads and seed pearls.
Miss United Kingdom, Kirsty Roper.
The second runner-up is Miss United Kingdom.
Well, that's Kirsty Roper. She'll leave tonight with a cheque for £1,000, second runner-up to Miss World.
Miss United Kingdom.
Suzanne Younger is wearing a black figure-hugging dress with Spanish-style sleeves trimmed with white ribbon. The dress flows into a fishtail at the bottom of the skirt, which is also trimmed with black. She completes the outfit with diamante and jet matching jewelry.
From the United Kingdom, Miss Claire Smith.
The way you're looking at me. Oh, it's for the only one.
The runner-up and the second princess, Miss United Kingdom.
Miss United Kingdom.
Melanie is studying modern languages at university, and her ambition is to study film and television in New York, and then to work in news presentation or documentaries. Her hobbies include swimming and writing. She speaks English, French, Arabic, and is learning Spanish.
To Miss United Kingdom.
Ladies and gentlemen, as you all know, the United Kingdom is grieving the loss of a fellow ambassador, Princess Diana. It has taken this tragic accident to unite not only a nation, but the whole of the world.
To be in TV and is diplomatic, optimistic, fun, and sensitive. Oh, and her prized possession is a Roger Rabbit teddy bear, cuddly.
Second runner-up is Miss Scotland.
Secured a fast-track place in the final 15 for Wales.
That next contestant from Northern Europe is Northern Ireland. Miss Northern Ireland.
Northern Ireland had won everyone's heart with a soulful rendition of an Irish ballad. Her haunting performance brought the house down and put her into the semi-final.
Great performance from the winner of this year's talent contest. Please welcome Northern Ireland. Judge's choice to go into the semi-final is Scotland.
But the winner of the Miss World Sportswomen 2010 was Northern Ireland.
Little Northern Ireland in the finals of Miss World.
There, and sure enough, it is Northern Ireland. Congratulations! That was a tough one to pass.
Hi, I'm Nicola Mimna. I'm 24 and I'm representing Scotland. I am a full-time model. I've been modelling for 3 years since I left university. I studied business and politics and didn't really know where I wanted to go with it, so I started modelling and I've been travelling about, been to Dubai, Milan, loads of different places modelling, and it's been great.
Finalist number three will be... England!
That's Elise Mounter. She's studying journalism at the moment, described herself as a kind, generous, down-to-earth sort of person.
Lucky number seven's going to be... Scotland!
Jennifer Rioch is a keen sportswoman. She enjoys athletics, netball, and horse riding, not to mention Scottish country dancing.
Congratulations!
Hello, my name is Tiffany Bryan, and I'm this year's Miss Northern Ireland. I'm 21 years old, and I'm currently studying marketing. I'm a very keen sportswoman, and prior to winning my title, I was on the Irish Olympic sailing team. I also love to travel and bake cakes. An ambition of mine is to represent my country at the Olympic Games. I would also love to pursue a career in sports media.
In eighth place, England.
England.
In seventh place,
our seventh finalist is...
Mexico!
place. Wales.
Ellie McKeating, and I'm representing Scotland at Miss World 2014. Something interesting you may not know about me is that I have a real passion for snow sports, and I've been travelling all over the world with my family skiing since the tender age of 4. To all the Scots back home, I know I'm only down the road, but I miss you all very much already. Keep up the continued support.
Goes to the host country, England!
Senior student doctor at the University of Cambridge. I had to work extremely hard to get into Cambridge, and I've had to also work very hard in this competition. Over 120 countries are represented. What an experience. I've never had that, and to find another situation where women, young women, are being represented all across the globe.
Hello, I'm Leanne. I'm from a small town called Cookstown in Northern Ireland. Business is my passion. I am a marketing student at the Ulster University, Jordanstown. I fulfilled my lifelong dream of creating my own business at the age of just 18, where I set up an e-commerce fashion business. We now ship worldwide. A fun fact about my country is that English is the most widely spoken language, but the most widely spoken minority language is Chinese.
My name is Mary Ferguson, and I'm representing Scotland. I'm a recent graduate from Glasgow Caledonian University, where I studied international fashion branding. An interesting fact about me is that I've been snow skiing and water skiing since the age of 3. My Beauty with a Purpose is to raise awareness of epilepsy, which is a condition very close to my heart as I was diagnosed at the age of 13.
England!
Hello, my name is Stephanie Hill. I'm 22 years of age and I'm honoured to represent England. I have recently qualified as a therapeutic radiographer, obtaining a first-class Bachelor of Science with Honours degree in radiotherapy and oncology.
In third place is England.
Northern Ireland.
In the future, I would love to continue working as a nurse and work more with teenagers and their mental health. At the minute, I work with babies, so I want to expand my role a bit more.
And the last from Europe is Scotland! How about a top 12? And one of them will become Miss World Europe.
So, going on to my Beauty with a Purpose, it's about prevention campaign on the type 2 diabetes. I believe the role of a doctor is not just treatment, it's also prevention. Mm-hmm. You know, and I chose diabetes because in the West, we have a problem of obesity, and diabetes is very prevalent. It's very close to home for myself.
So my Beauty with a Purpose project started 3.5 years ago, and it was a result of my experience with my granddad. So in his later life, he was diagnosed with dementia. And I remember as a kid just fascinated by him. He always had amazing conversations. He was always the centre of the room. And I remember so excited to grow up to be a woman and have those conversations with him and be a part of that dialogue.
My Beauty with a Purpose project is one that is very close to my heart and I'm very passionate about. Mm-hmm. It revolves around domestic abuse and domestic violence. And my aim really is to raise as much awareness and as much funds as possible that I can in to help women and young children mm-hmm. who have been affected by domestic abuse. I've been an ambassador and volunteer for 5 years already.
My name is Rahema Muthamia. I'm 24 years old and I'm proud to be in the first ever Miss All African Colours England competition.
Scotland 2021 is Claudia Todd.